How do you help a teenager or young adult with anxiety? In this video, you'll hear from certified psychotherapist Marc Azoulay as he shares practical ways parents or loved ones can support their child who is struggling with anxiety. Hey, it's Clint with Sandstone Care, where we help teens, young adults, and their families overcome challenges that come with substance use, addiction, and mental health conditions. All right, let's get right to it. How do you help a teenager or a young adult with anxiety?
So the number one thing to do is just to listen, right? Just to listen and to try to enter their world as they allow it, right? I was going to say as much as possible, but it's more like as they allow it, because then that's a little bit invasive. But what that looks like is being interested in what they're interested in. Even something that might be boring to you as an adult, right? If they're really interested in a video game or, a streamer or, they're interested in some esoteric hobby or whatever, right? Or fashion that you don't quite understand. I think as the adult, it's really on you to take a step back and to put all that aside and just be interested in your child. And especially with young adults, they're not going to tell you the emotional content first, right? If you go up to your kid and you're like, hey, you're really anxious, you want to talk about it? That's way too intense. That's way too intense for them, right? I mean, to be fair, it's way too intense for most adults, right? Like, no one wants to answer that question, especially if your relationship with your teen or your young adult is maybe a little bit rocky or maybe a little bit distant. They're not going to go straight to the core. So a lot of relationship building needs to happen, which means, again, entering their world. And you'll see that it'll come up. If you sit and watch a YouTube video with them that they really enjoy, at the end of that, they might just share something with you about how that video relates to their life or something that they're afraid of at school or a situation that's arising, because they're going to feel that level of connection with you. They're going to feel closer. And I think it's a mistake that a lot of parents make is that they try to bring the kid into their world, which is part of your role as a parent, right? You want them to grow up and learn about the world and be an adult, but it's also on the parent's job to come down into their world and to play, really, to play with them so that that safety and trust can be built up. I think it's critical because that's how they process the world, right? Like, a kid processes almost entirely through play. And I used to work, I did some child therapy early in my career. And it's wild that once you build safety with these kids, they would start playing, house or playing with dolls or playing with cars. And they would be telling the stories of their family through their play because their brain wasn't developed enough to communicate it effectively. But they'd be like, oh, here's like the mommy doll and the daddy doll. And like they're fighting and oh no, like the kid is hiding in the basement. Right? I mean, they would like, that would be the game that they were playing, And it was also clear just to watch it and see how that would happen. The same thing is going to happen with your teen and young adult, right? I remember, I think most of you have this experience. You probably had this experience, Clint, where like the music you listen to as a teen speaks for your soul. And if you as a parent, if you just listen to some of their music, you're going to understand so much about your teen, even if it doesn't sound like a genre that you like or you don't understand what it's really about. Like, just listen and you're going to be like, whoa. Like, my teen is really sad. He's into a lot of really sad stuff. Or, whoa, my teen's listening to a lot of angry stuff. Wonder what they're angry about. You can start to see what's going on underneath the hood if you can get more into your teen and young adult's world and try to understand what draws them, right? Like, what they're interested in.
Marc, when you mentioned music, I immediately knew exactly what you were talking about. I remember as a kid, especially listening to the radio. And the radio is kind of a unique situation because it's constantly putting music out there that you may not know about, right? Like, you're not searching for it. It's just kind of putting it out there. And I would always look for these songs that were kind of able to express what I didn't yet have words for, right? That would be the way I would connect, because here I had people who were adults, I'm assuming, because they're making music, right? And they're famous, they're on the radio, and they're eloquent enough to be able to describe their emotions. And so much of what I struggled to do as a kid was just to describe how I felt. And so when you found an artist or when you found a song that was able to do that, it was something that was sublime, right? It made you feel so happy because you felt understood. And so much of what we wanted to do is just feel understood. I don't know if you can relate to that.
Oh, 100%. No, 100%. I watched it started my kind of, what I credit the start of my whole kind of introspective therapy, self whatever journey, was watching The Wall, the Pink Floyd movie, right? Which is essentially a giant music video for that album. And just seeing that and seeing how closed off that character was, seeing how chaotic that character was, seeing how much pain. And it's both put through, you know, the incredible music and through just like really intense visuals. That just broke me open. I remember crying, like just breaking down and crying and being like, oh my God, I didn't know I felt this. I mean, kind of the same thing you said, right? It's like this thing is putting into words and visuals what I've been feeling for a long time. And I felt so much not alone because like, at least there's one person, right? There's someone who wrote the song that feels that way. Not to mention, you know, that movie's out there and people enjoy it. So there's many people that feel the same way. Really life-changing. I think that really started me on getting in touch with my emotions at all.
Yeah. And when I think about the animal kingdom, even, you know, play is such a huge part of how they learn how to do things, how they learn how to hunt, how they learn how to communicate with each other, how they learn how to do the essential things that are so important for them. And if they don't spend that time playing, then they don't learn those essential skills, right? So, you know, you see a lion cub stalking its, you know, a butterfly through the grass, right? And it's doing this to be able to try and learn how to do this skill. Right? It's mimicking what it sees. And so having a chance to play allows us to lower our defenses, allows us to be able to be in the moment, and also allows us to just do an experience with someone, right? Which is something that is hard to do with social media because you're kind of putting something out there, seeing responses, but it's not this coinciding thing. It's not like a conversation kind of like we're having right now, which the two of us are, you know, just talking to each other. So I can see that as being so important. I never thought about it that way.
Yeah, no, I think you hit the nail on the head. It's so true. And it also creates bonding moments with your teen. It creates memories that you can share together. Be like, oh, remember when we did that and I fell over and it was funny, right? You know, or like, oh my God, like you really knocked out the park with that one or whatever, right? Those are those moments that the kid is going to remember a lot more than even a conversation that you have or, you know, a lesson that you try to impart to them. They're going to remember those little moments of play that happen spontaneously that are generated through, you know, the freedom from inhibition, like you talked about. That's what they're going to remember. And that's what's going to help them feel more connected to you.
And guess what? That doesn't stop when it comes to, you know, the relationship between parent and child, right? Like you get married or you're in a relationship with someone. Oftentimes, if you want to be able to connect with that person, you have to engage in similar interests, right? If you want to build a friendship, you have to engage in similar interests. And sometimes those are things that you're comfortable with, that you have experience with, but then sometimes they're not, right? Sometimes throughout that process, you learn that this actually is kind of interesting. Every parent who I've ever seen do a TikTok with their kid, like a dance with their kid, like hats off to them because they're engaging in a platform that is, you know, different. They're willing to look silly or goofy. And at the same time, they're doing something that's interesting to their kid. Now, your kid may not want to do a TikTok with you, right? But that doesn't mean that you can't be willing to engage in whatever interest they are willing to do with you.
Yeah, and that's what we're talking about, right? To loop back around, that is what helps them with anxiety because you're entering their world, you're interested in what they're interested in. And I would imagine after going through that TikTok, shooting it a couple times, you know, having a couple bad takes, your kid's going to feel a lot closer to you and over time will trust you enough to reduce the fear level, right? Right? Their trust reduces fear, safety reduces fear so that they can start to talk to you about what's actually going on for them, right? You can become a safer person for them to connect with. And it probably helps them feel like they're anxious in the house, right?
If you want to learn more about treatment options for you, your teen, or young adult, then tell us about your situation on a confidential call using the number in the description box below, or live chat with us at sandstonecare.com. We'll connect you with the treatment that you need, and if we're not the right fit, we'll get you where you need to go. Be well, and remember that change is possible.